share of God's goodness. Father, we thank you again for your love, your greatness, your goodness, your blessings, and all of your manifold benefits. We thank you today, Father, for the work that you've begun in us. We thank you, God, that the work that you have begun, you will continue to perform it. Our eyes are upon you. You're the author. You're the finisher of our faith. We give you praise and the glory. In Jesus' name, everybody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. We've been speaking from the subject recently, six keys. Everybody say six keys. To stay in focus spiritually. And we have our shared with you, I think, three of the principles. Number one, self-restraint or self-discipline. We've shared that at length. Secondly, persistence in prayer. Everybody just said persistence in prayer, all right? And we pointed out that in prayer with thanksgiving, that's the thing that makes your prayer effectual. Your fervent prayer of the righteous avails much, but there must be persistence in prayer and thanksgiving. Amen. Sometimes we don't realize how important Thanksgiving is. Amen. God wants us to be really, really happy. Rejoice evermore. And the Bible says that the joy of the Lord would be our what? Strength. Amen. So God wants us to be full. Everybody just said full. Full of joy. Full. Amen. Full of joy. And the only way that we can be full of joy is that we have to cultivate the spirit of thanksgiving. We have to cultivate that. Praise God for everything that he has done. How many can say amen?
Amen.
How many know it's easy to praise God for the things that he's brought you through?
Amen.
Amen. But also, we need to praise God for the things that we are believing him to bring us through.
Amen.
This is very important to your faith, because this is the way you act your faith. Faith without actions is what?
Dead.
So if you believe in God for something, you need to get in a thanksgiving mode. Touch somebody and just say, you hear the pastor? You need, these long drawn faces and looking wise and otherwise and amen, full of fear and worry and anxiety. That won't cause your prayer to what? Prevail. Amen. God said, I'll do great things for you if you rejoice. Amen. This is what we call offering the sacrifice. Amen. The sacrifice. You know, I don't think that many of us have gotten that yet. The sacrifice of thanksgiving is praising God in advance for the things that he has promised you that he would do. I'm not sure everybody has gotten that. Because the scripture says, in everything, what? Give thanks. For this is the will of God concerning us in Christ Jesus. So I'm just throwing these things out again, because many times we don't receive the answers to our prayers. But I think that many times the atmosphere has not been developed for God to answer your prayer. Because God is not going to answer prayer just because you look long-faced. Because you look what? Strange and crazy. You know, God honors what? Faith. And you know what God calls faith? Delay. Amen. This is what we're trying to cultivate, amen, in worship. And a bunch of people just what? Delighting in the Lord. I mean, just woo. And I think that we're going to have to get back to dancing too. How many of us danced and got the victory? Some of us don't even know what dancing in the spirit is. Well, that's something that I'm going to let Brother Dean help us with. All right, so when we can get back to rejoicing, you will see the glory of the Lord returning to the church. Amen. So I'm just going to make a big ado. Amen. I'm going to sing in the spirit. I'm going to holler loud sometimes. I'm going to lift up my voice like a trumpet. Amen. I'm going to dance, I'm going to shout, I'm going to cry, I'm going to weep, I'm going to break. I'm going to let go and let God. Because God is doing, he's carrying me somewhere. Amen. I mean, I'm in a place now that I've never been in before. Amen. That's the reason why I know a financial breakthrough is coming, and then we can have a lot more resources to really bring people in and to get all everything in place that's needed in order for us to really begin to sow as a ministry. The reason why I know that is because, amen, there are some things that God will do for you if you just be faithful. The scripture says he is a what? Rewarder of them that will what? Diligently seek him. Amen. Praise God. So God has given us grace. A lot of favor is on a lot of you people here. A lot of favor. The grace of God is on your life. And I believe that there are some here are destined to be millionaires. Amen. Destined to be. You're faithful. Keep rejoicing. Keep seeing the things that be not as though they are. Amen. How many of you got to see the end before the beginning? You got to see the end. You got to see yourself having what arrived. And I see myself standing before 200 or 300 bishops and several hundred pastors sharing my material. I'm almost there. Oh my God. End time things that God has given. How many remember the end time things that we've taught the last several weeks? Amen. I'm almost there. And then I got some meditation material to release. Boy, I'm telling you, that will blow your mind. Next time I stand before those bishops and elders and all over the country, hallelujah. Little on me. From nowhere, hallelujah. And, you know, it's very difficult to convince people that you are about something if they came to this church and just saw just these few people. It's hard to convince that you got anything from God. But how many know God can work against the odds? I guarantee you, in the circles where I'm going, I guarantee you won't find a pastor, or an elder, or an evangelist, or a bishop, anybody that have the quality of material that I have shared with you all for all these years. Amen. So I don't know whether God wants to bless me entirely through that source, but that's just one stream, one avenue that God wants to bless me. Amen. And if I just keep on praising God. Y'all think I'm crazy sometimes. Y'all want to cut the witch of all sometimes. Oh, let's move on to the office. I can't go to the offering. Amen. Sometimes when the offering time comes, it's time to what? To worship. Amen. It just don't always kick in 30 minutes. Amen. Now, if you're on a little schedule, 15 minutes this, 15 minutes this, we got a program. Amen. You do this, next, next. Amen. But I believe that those that worship the Lord must worship him in what? Spirit and in truth. Amen. So I'm getting... In prayer on Monday night, I'm just getting crazy. Amen. Praise God. I know I mess up the prayer meeting sometimes. Sometimes I say, well, Pastor, you always sing in the Spirit. Amen. I'm trying to get y'all to sing in the Spirit a little bit more, right? Some of y'all catch that. But let me tell you, suppose you sing in the Spirit for 6 hours. Woo! 6 hours. Or maybe just 1 hour, huh? And then let's go slow. Oh, talking about the anointing filling my house, Brother Rico. Amen. You know, sometimes it gets kind of monotonous when you just try to pray the Spirit, you know, for 2 or 3 hours. I have found that many times people, if they do the same kind of praying in the Spirit for, you know, 30 minutes, an hour, it gets kind of dull. But let me tell you, because when you begin to sing in the Spirit, it's always a new song. It's always a new thing. And it's not the same song. Just say, you're a singer. Amen. And Brother Dean wants to help us to get a choir. That's why you put all these singers back in. He'll teach you how, he'll lead you in singing in the spirit too. Oh, praise the Lord. Come on, lift your hands and praise the Lord. Our blessings are so limited because we just, you know, sometimes we just don't give God the glory that He's due. I want to go wild over the Lord. He's done so much for me. Amen. Hallelujah. My brother that's passed on, he said, amen, James, you'll never be any good in this life. He said, I pity the woman that marries you. You know, that's when those sawing wood days, y'all know about those cutting soils, trying to cut enough wood for a whole week and cross-cut saw the buckshaw, y'all remember that?
Yeah. Right.
Cutting down trees and cutting the tree up, splitting the blocks and making what? The wood for the stove. Boy, I hated that. Oh, I hated that. Man, it took all day even just to cut a little wood. Oh, Jesus. And my brother got so aggravated with me, he said, man, I pity, man, you the sorriest boy I've ever seen in my life, and I pity the woman that marries you. All right, but Sister Hill ain't too pitiful, is she? She likes to be, she's in pretty good shape. Oh, wow, amen. But let me tell you, I wouldn't trade nothing for the place that God has brought me. Although from the outward appearance, it seems like, you know, I'm not going anywhere. But from, amen, seeing through the eyes of faith, the eyes of God, well, I see the end result of what God has brought me to and where God is leading me, amen, to possess the land. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hey, and the more I see the end result, that's the reason why I can sing in the spirit, I can rejoice, and I can praise God. Amen. Even when, like last month, I had to use some of the money y'all gave me for anniversary, I had to go back and just get that to pay the bill. Oh, you heard me. All right. Oh, it hurt. Oh, it hurt. Oh. Amen. And Sister Hill, she don't agree with stuff like that. But sometimes you just go on and give in. Amen. Amen. But yet, I still rejoice. Because I see the end result of my faith, amen, is going to begin to be is more precious than anything that I can see and that I can have even in the natural. Amen. So I just want you all to hold fast to your confession of faith without wavering, because we are destined, if some in this church are destined to become millionaires.
All
right. Amen. Then, once, amen, I mean, when God makes some of us millionaires, y'all know, it's got to be God. Is that right? It's got to be what? The favor. It's got to be what? The favor. The favor, the favor of God. Amen. Praise God. I'm just depending and thanking God for His favor. Amen. Grace is God doing something for you that you can't do for yourself.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Let's say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
All right. I just wanted to focus on that Thanksgiving thing, because that's a real issue, because as we go from one step to the other, amen, Thanksgiving is going to be the key that will take us from one step, one level, amen, to the other. The third level that we focus on, we call these six keys. The third thing was stay humble. Everybody just say stay humble. Amen. Now, we understand James 4:6. This is a very important scripture that I want you to see. God resisteth the proud, but He giveth grace to the humble. He giveth grace to the humble. Amen. Everybody just say, God resisteth the proud. But He gives what? Grace to the what? To the humble. Now, the scripture that we Great, last week, Isaiah 66:2, for all those things hath mine hand made. This is Isaiah 66:2. And those things have been, saith the Lord. But to this man will I look, even to him that is poor and of a contrite spirit, and trembleth at my word. That is the person that God's favor will always follow. If you really want to know why some people enjoy the favor of God and others do not have the favor of God in their life, this is one of the key scriptures. It says that, but to this man will I look, even to him that is poor. Amen. I don't mean poor in purse. That means poor in spirit. A person that is humble, a person that is dependent and looking to God to do for them what they're not able to do for themselves. Amen. God is going to show them favor if they depend on Him. If they say, Lord, I don't have what it takes. I'm not sufficient of myself to do anything of myself. But my sufficiency, Lord, is of you. When you get to that point, when you become bankrupt, poverty stricken, when you become lanky, lean, and lacking, when you feel, amen, that you have come to the end of your strength and your ability, that you no longer can do it within you, amen, your own power, amen, that's the point where God's grace is going to be released into your life. Amen. I thank God for His grace. Hallelujah. He's able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can what? Think or ask. But it will pay us to what? To look to God's grace. Amen. Quit depending on your little what? Lanky, lean, limited wisdom or knowledge or strength or ability. God wants you to be totally what? Dependent upon Him. How many know God is able to keep you from falling? Hey! How many know He's able to present you faultless before His presence with what? Exceeding joy! Woo! I don't know about y'all, I'm just going to keep on rejoicing. I'm going to keep on rejoicing until God fills this church. Hey, I'm going to keep on rejoicing until, amen, with that 30 voice choir, or whatever number we want it to be, we'll be in place on Sunday morning. Hey, I'm going to keep on rejoicing until the finances needed to what? To get God's, amen, kingdom into what? Into place, into focus. Hey, whatever is needed for the kingdom. Amen. We just keep it coming. Everybody just say, let's rejoice. Tallest hills in Greenville, Gilcrease, Union Hill. Yeah. Every time I do my walk.